It was supposed to be humane. You strap the condemned down to a chair, then seal him in an airtight chamber. Finally, once the time has come for the prisoner's life to come to an end, lethal gas is pumped into the room, ensuring a speedy and painless death. A humane approach to the death penalty for society's most violent criminals only turns out that death in the gas chamber is anything but painless and far from humane. In the early 20th century, most states in the US were still hanging people, which, if you've seen our previous episodes on worst punishments, you'll know that hanging very often didn't quite go to plan. On paper, it seems simple. You hoist the condemned up on a gallows, put a noose around their neck, and drop them through a trapdoor. Contrary to popular opinion, the condemned didn't die from asphyxiation, but rather from the sudden drop snapping their neck. A clean, fast death. Except it hardly ever went to plan. And when hanging went wrong, it went real wrong. Like when Kendall Jenner solved racism by drinking Pepsi wrong. For starters, dropping a prisoner from too large a height would end up with the head being popped clean off like a champagne cork, showering curious bystanders with a fountain of gore. Dropping them from too low, the neck wouldn't break, leaving everyone staring awkwardly for several minutes as the condemned very slowly choked to death. Clearly, there had to be a better solution, and this is where the government turned to gas. Once more, on paper, it seems like a simple, clean death. A lethal gas is pumped into an airtight room, and the prisoner lapses into unconsciousness and soon thereafter a painless death. Once more, the reality was anything but the humane death that was hoped for. So how does execution by lethal gas work? And how does it go so very wrong? First, you have to decide on a type of gas to be used. Executions can go with either a poisonous gas or an asphyxiant gas. A poisonous gas typically kills by causing massive organ failure, shutting down vital organs, and bringing on death. An asphyxiant gas typically makes it difficult for the lungs to get enough oxygen, or blocks the absorption of oxygen into the bloodstream. During World War II, the Nazis, probably the most infamous mass gassers in history, used carbon monoxide to asphyxiate dozens of people at a time. This had the advantage of making cleanup and transportation of the gas safe and simple. Typically, the gas was created on the spot by running a large engine fed by diesel or gasoline. But manufacturing carbon monoxide was also produced to try to speed up the killing process. It was still a slow process, however, with executions sometimes taking up to half an hour or more to complete. Zyklon B, originally used as a pesticide, was rapidly found to be a superior solution. Unlike carbon monoxide, which kills by asphyxiation, Zyklon B directly attacks the body's cells, shutting down organs and bringing death in as little as 2 minutes. At the same time that fumigators in the US were using Zyklon B to keep insect pests under control, the Nazis were using it to run the largest mass murder operation in history. The United States opted for the use of sodium cyanide for its executions, which was believed to be a fast and pain-free method of death. The procedure was simple. The prisoner was strapped into a chair placed in an airtight chamber. Underneath the chair would be a container filled with sulfuric acid and distilled water. Then, from the safety of outside the chamber, the executioner would pull a lever, causing sodium cyanide crystals to drop into the water acid solution, releasing hydrocyanic gas. The inmate would have been instructed to breathe deeply so as to hasten unconsciousness. However, most inmates would hold their breath as long as they could. Regardless, at some point the victim would go unconscious as the cyanide entered their body and the cyanide ions bound to the iron atoms inside the mitochondria of the living cells. The bonding would prevent cellular respiration, leading to the shutdown of the body's organs. Death at the cellular level. What could possibly go wrong with that? Turns out, a lot of things. It's been discovered with lethal injection, with some executions taking up to a whopping 2 hours, each person's biology is different, and people's bodies can react in extremely unpredictable ways. Of over 600 executions by gas in the US, so many of these would go so significantly wrong that at one point a prison warden commented that if he was forced to kill another inmate with gas, he would quit his job. Inmates would be seen drooling and moaning long after they should have been unconscious. On September 2, 1983, Jimmy Lee Gray was executed by lethal gas, and after 8 minutes of moaning and banging his head against a pipe, the viewing room was cleared by prison officials. It's unknown just how long it took for him to actually die. In 1960, Carl Chessman told reporters he would nod his head if he felt pain during the execution. Chessman would nod his head for several minutes as he moaned behind the thick glass, until at last falling unconscious. Pain and unconsciousness are difficult things to study, so it's not known exactly how death by lethal gas is as painful as it apparently is. Experts, however, believe that the sensation of death by gas is similar to the extreme pain of a heart attack. only extended over several minutes at a time as the gas slowly works to bring death. After so many horror stories from the gas chamber executions, the method has been largely banned in the US, with the last execution by gas chamber taking place in 1999. Today, prisoners can still get the gas chamber in Arizona, California, Maryland, Mississippi, Missouri, and Wyoming, though only if lethal injection cannot be administered. With the effectiveness of lethal injection also in serious question, however, states are once more looking for a new and humane method of execution. Now, go check out How Does Lethal Injection Work? What happens if it fails? Or click this other video instead.